One of the more fascinating rookie stories this year, at least for the guys who are not contributing a lot on offense or defense or not getting consistent playing time and opportunities, is N'Kobe Dean. We all, you know, watched and listened to the draft and how he fell after being, you know, universally acclaimed and recognized as the best inside linebacker in the country last year in college football, which he was for the national champions, Georgia. And he's gotten an opportunity to play some defense in the last 2 weeks. Now, granted, it was two blowout wins for the Eagles as they just continue to roll. It's against the Titans and the Giants. I'm going to show you a little bit of film. Some of the things that some of us have pointed out in the pre-draft process still kind of persist in terms of a couple of small negatives. But when he's allowed to play, when he's put in the right position, N'Kobe Dean looks like a guy who can play at this level. There's no question about it. I think he had five tackles, maybe six, in 15 snaps against the Titans in Week 13. One tackle against the Giants this past week. Show you a couple of things and concerns that we had with stance and consistency of alignment, dating back to even Georgia, and then pass drops. How far improved he is when he's got some awareness of the receiver versus just staring at the quarterback. So this is designed to be like an 8 to 10 minute video. N'Kobe Dean will be highlighted before each play generally. Again, this is going to be like late third quarter, fourth quarter of the last two games generally. There'll be one kickoff in here. He's a heat seeker on kickoff. I feel like he's, at least from what I've seen, he's on their kickoff often. This is late in the game against the Giants. Of course, they blew them out. When he can react to something quickly, like quick passes, I feel like he can have a real impact in the pass game. He's a guy who can tackle to the boundary against anyone. And what I mean by to the boundary is there's the ball on that hash. So this is the short side of the field, the boundary. Whereas over here, you have more space. That's the field. He's generally located to the boundary when the ball is on the hash, at least from what I see. The nickel defender is away from him. Well, that's a good thing. It takes advantage of N'Kobe Dean's athleticism and quick concepts that get the ball out quick and allow him to just react to the boundary. I feel like he's going to be able to cover up that boundary even without a nickel defender there to support like the field side linebacker has. Again, to the boundary side, a 2x2 set. Running back is on the opposite side here. Nickel is away. N'Kobe Dean, I feel like, has a lot of reps where he is doing this in the pass game, where he's looking in the backfield, and that's what a lot of people do now. I understand that, but no check at all to the vertical or seam here or anything that, you know, could be developing underneath or maybe even, you know, a drag, something like that. The eyes very rarely flash to the outside, and that's something that some of us had talked about and pointed out in the pre-draft process, because of how many coverages Georgia played, how multiple they were, which was to their benefit, don't get me wrong, I felt like that allowed N'Kobe Dean to have some inconsistencies in his pass drops. I'm not saying that he's no good at it. I'm saying that relative to all the other strengths he has, athleticism, recognition, awareness, speed, relative to all those other strengths, I would consider that to be his weakness. And maybe that's one of the reasons he's not on the field as much. Very reactive to the quarterback. I'm disappointed in this rep personally, and I think that the coaches noticed it. I could be wrong. The very next play, you'll see the linebackers have switched. This disappoints me because you end up with, I think it's Tyrod Taylor, scrambling out here. You know, you haven't played a lot of defense this year. I think prior to Week 13, N'Kobe Dean had only played like two or three snaps on defense. I just want for him to be hair on fire, running towards the sideline as this quarterback breaks contain, and I just don't see that. Granted, it's a blowout game, and the Eagles are rolling, so it doesn't impact the the outcome. But I have a feeling that this could be one of the things that coaches look at times if they want to be super critical and say, hey, man, this is one of the reasons why you're not getting on the field a ton. Do I know that to be true? No, I don't. All right, the very next play, all right, another pass play. And first of all, when he is connected to or aware of the receivers to his outside, he's in great relationship. There is no doubt. My concern when he takes pass drops, particularly in zone, is that he has no awareness of the routes that are developing to his outside, or some people say behind them. When he does this is clearly, you know, man to the boundary. or a bracket. You know, they're probably in trap. The corner's jumping inside. The safety's running over the top. So he's responsible for two vertical because they're looking for you know, something like this possibly, and the corner can jump it. So he's responsible for the inside leverage man of the number two tight end. My point is, athletically, ability-wise, recognition-wise, he has awareness of receivers. Now, let me talk about and reference that previous play. Remember, he was up here, Tyrod Taylor, you know, scrambled out to one side, and he clearly wasn't getting it. He just wasn't getting it. Watch this guy. I don't even know who this guy is. I think it's Elise, who's making a lot of tackles late in games for them. Look at the effort. Granted, it's a blowout game. The game is, you know, determined at this point, but coaches notice those things. Coaches for other teams notice those things when they're looking for guys to maybe trade for, or they remember a play from the year before and say, hey, this is a guy who goes after it every single time he's on the field versus that previous rep. You tell me, I'm going to show this one more time. It's not a big deal, but I want for N'Kobe Dean to get more opportunities. If I was, you know, someone around him, I would say, like, you can't do what you did on the last play. Compare it to this rep. If you think I'm being, you know, overly critical, let me know. I just rewound it to the previous rep. There he is to the top side. Again, it's going to be a scramble, pass play, late in the game. Giants are down by a lot. I just don't feel like that's N'Kobe Dean's best effort. That's everything N'Kobe Dean's got. I think that's pretty obvious. And it's not done from a standpoint of this is who he is. Like, he's a 22-year-old guy. Hopefully he looks at the film and makes adjustments and doesn't do those things again. All right, same play from the end zone angle. Not the one where he kind of loafed it, but the one where he's responsible for the tight end up the seam. Again, when he gets a pass read and he's got some type of responsibility that allows him to be aware of the, or encourages, influences him to be aware of the wide receiver, he's absolutely capable of doing so. I wonder why in some of these zones he doesn't have more of a head flip, a head turn to try to get, you know, awareness of the receivers developing outside of him. Okay, let's rewind 1 week ahead. What was his best performance so far this year on defense? A 5 or 6 tackle game against the Titans. He's the 3 on the Eagles' left on kickoff. He's getting it. He's a heat seeker. It shows you his ability, his athletic ability, his willingness to get to the football. I'll rewind it in a second so you can see the whole play or part of the play as it relates to him. So this is him right here. Hopefully the resolution for you guys is good. You can see he's closing down as the ball is committed to the bottom of the numbers. If there's any chance for this ball to come back, you know, to the top of the numbers, N'Kobe Dean can't close this down too early. He's got all this help to the inside. So he's a real aware football player. Great on kickoff. I don't think he played a whole lot of kickoff at Georgia, but the NFL changes those dynamics, obviously, for a lot of guys early in their career. All right, this is Derrick Henry late in the game. I think it's an 18-point lead. Maybe I'm wrong there. I may be misremembering. That might be the Giants score when he got in. And that's Derrick Henry in the backfield. So the Titans are still playing football. I got Ryan Tannehill. I like how he takes on this lineman, sheds him. Yeah, he catches, you know, in terms of the running back, but he's dealing with an NFL lineman and then trying to tackle Derrick Henry. He did get credit for the tackle. Didn't see this a lot at Georgia, me personally. Well, granted, they had studs at D-tackle and then Trayvon Walker as well that really overwhelmed people's offensive line. Didn't see this. This type of fundamental pads below pads, using the hands to take on an offensive lineman. You saw a lot of, you know, dipping around blocks, which there is a time and place to do, don't get me wrong. So me personally, like, even though I know that I spent some time in the first part of this video being a little critical, like, I think that he's moving closer to being able to get on the field. Is it going to be this year? You know, it certainly doesn't look like it because of the other talent that they have and how well they're playing. Again, another reaction quick to the boundary. Well, actually, it's to the field. My apologies. More so wide side to his side, but I don't think he's got the nickel defender out there. It's like a snag flat concept. And because he's looking at the quarterback, he's able to react so quickly. On quick passes, three-step stuff, I feel like he's going to be an asset because of his speed, his willingness to get after the ball. You can see he's looking right at Tannehill. Ball's thrown. Boom, getting out of there. Intermediate routes are routes that get over the top of him. I think he's going to, he would not be able to defend properly because he doesn't have awareness of the routes, at least in zone. Some of the coverages that Georgia played last year, he was up at the line of scrimmage, so up here, and then turning and running and actually looking at receivers as the routes developed, and he was great at that. So I think it's going to be something that as he gets more reps in the NFL, it won't be a concern. There's the routes that are run. One slight criticism would be I don't feel like he's in a great stance early enough for me, but my opinion means nothing, you know, compared to the guys that are coaching him, obviously. Other people don't evaluate stance. They just evaluate, you know, the stats. And certainly his stats haven't been great this year, but this is a great example of what he's capable of. You got the snag flat concept. This receiver is supposed to pick him. N'Kobe Dean gets redirected. Look at that. And then just keeps on going. So the level of athleticism that he's got, athleticism, strength, ability to play through contact, it's all there. You'd like to see him wrap up a little bit better on that tackle on the sideline. I'm not trying to be overly critical, but these might be some of the reasons why he's not getting on the field as much. Again, a zone defense, and I want to compare him to the inside linebacker on the other side. So I'm going to talk about these two guys in a moment. I'll let it run maybe twice and let you guys notice stuff before I mention it, because it's quite possible you notice elements that I don't. And then if so, then put them in the comment section. Now it's trips, all right? Technically quads, but you got a running back over here. It's a single receiver to the backside. But watch this guy get out of here and actually take his eyes and look this way a little bit versus N'Kobe Dean, who is all on the quarterback. Now, there's times where he's in a spy mode. Don't get me wrong. It could be the situation. It's 3rd and 11, though. It's Ryan Tannehill at quarterback. I'm not sure that you have to go QB spy. I think we're being a little bit generous if we're just assuming that it's a QB spy situation. It could be, but with his penchant for not really having awareness or showing that he's trying to find awareness of receivers, in zone, I feel like that kind of sticks out compared to this guy here. Let me know what you think of that in the comment section. You know, you have a slot receiver that he's got there. If there's a slot receiver on the other side, is N'Kobe Dean going to have more awareness of him? Possibly. All right, a couple more plays from the Titans game. This is a nice job on an out concept by, I think this is Okonkwo, the other rookie from Maryland. I'll hopefully have a video out this weekend of him. Somewhat similar to the snag flat concept I showed you, except the number one's not running the snag, but he is trying to veer inside towards N'Kobe Dean, the inside linebacker defender who's inside leverage. Watch him chase this. Short gain, good throw. You'd like to see him be a little bit closer, but he's challenging the play with his arm. I think he's way more capable as a pass defender than we see at times. Is there times where the protection is asking him to stare at the quarterback? Of course. Is there times where I think he could probably be a little bit more aware of receivers? Absolutely. These right here, these coverages, these routes, I think are the ones that he's going to play really, really well right now. Intermediate, deeper routes, digs, things that are going to develop, quote, behind him. I never refer to it that way with players. I think is the things that he would have a little bit more issue with. All right, later on in the game against the Titans, I think they've got Malik Willis in here. Great run read. Now, he's supported from the outside. I run this a couple of times so you can see it. Really gives you an idea of how he can play on downhill stuff. Look at his stance, too. Much better stance than some of the other plays. Even, I think, the next play I show you, he's not in a similar stance. He may be playing man-to-man on the next play, but I still would like to see more consistency in the stance so you're not giving away to the offense that we are playing man-to-man by your stance. And that is a real thing. Certain linebackers or second-level players do those things. Of course, if it's an obvious pass down, your stance may be different. I'll give you the end zone angle of this one because we ran that enough. Again, great stance. He is ready to explode. He's ready to move out of that stance. I think he's a great player, a great talent. I'm rooting for him, especially because his character and the way that people talked about him at Georgia, and then to see him fall in the draft so much because of various reasons, I'm rooting for him. I'm rooting for him to be a starter. I just don't know if it's going to be this year because of, you know, how good the other guys on the Eagles are, on the Eagles defense are. What do I mean when I say he's supported? You have a corner who's rolled up here, who could be the force player. You also have an edge defender who looks like he's stemming or stunting inside C gap. So the only gap N'Kobe Dean's got to worry about is this front side A gap. So as soon as it opens up, it's an open window. Go. Gone. Abrupt, quick, decisive, has the ability to finish plays. Really love the talent that's there. I think it was a great, smart choice by the Eagles, an investment in their future. I know there's been a lot of questions about the pick because he hasn't contributed much this year. This would be one where I would say to you that the stance is just too inconsistent for me at times. Only giving you the end zone angle, certainly looks like he's in man on the running back number 40. Personally, I wouldn't want to give away the coverage based upon what stance you are in pre-snap. I know there's going to be people in the comments section who say, Coach, you shouldn't be talking about the stance that much. There are giveaways. There are pre-snap indicators from D-linemen, from safeties, corners, etc. And there also are ones from linebackers. And I think that's an underrated element of some of the really, really high-level defenses across the NFL. Those guys are in great stances, and those guys are in consistent stances on every play. That and the pass drop issue is one of the things that I would say, me personally, based on my limited knowledge compared to the guys that are coaching him, I would want to see him improve on for N'Kobe Dean to reach his highest potential. If you're an Eagles fan or anyone else who's a fan of N'Kobe Dean, you know, let me know what you think of the breakdown in the comments section. And if you think I missed any elements of his play in weeks 13 and 14, please let me know. Appreciate you guys' time.